Must have been happy when that rumour came out, though.
It was brilliant. It was brilliant. I remember it was at Millwall. I remember walking in and someone just seen me and just started going. So I'm like, weird. And someone else is there and they're giving it back. And then I walked into the changing room and there's about like six lads there and they all just start applauding. So I'm like, oh, what's going on? Do you know what I mean? Like someone fill us in. So I said, go outside and have a look on the board. So I walked outside and it's just pinned on the board. It just said, Tony Warner's got the biggest tackle in football. So I'm kind of reading, I'm thinking, fucking hell, where's this come from? What advertising can it? Yeah, not complaining at all. So I'm reading it. I think McAteer had done some little piece in like some, it was like a more magazine, like a women's magazine. Well, McAteer being a handbag, you know what I mean? But it said like, it was the biggest in the shower. And he's got, definitely 100% Tony Warner. And he goes, and I'm second.
And I'm second.
Yeah.
So, fuck off, dude.
So they pull that out of the magazine and they just brought expose in the Daily Sport. So it was brilliant. So it runs out, gets about five Daily Sports. Do you know what I mean? And then,
that's one for the scrap
yeah,
up.
Yeah. So that was that then. It was just out there. So the Millwall fans were loving it. They were kind of shouting off the stands. You used to say, Denzel shows your cock and all that. So like, the most I could give them was I used to just pull my shorts up like that. Like as if I was looking down at it, and like look back up at the stand and all. They rouse with that. But yeah, that was a good bit of free advertising. That.